Good afternoon, JavaScripters. Good afternoon. I know it's very tough after a good lunch, especially after the Hasgeek lunch. So let's try one more time. Good afternoon, JavaScripters. I'm Arjun, and that's me 6 years ago. Okay, I'm here to talk about Tessel. How many of you are interested to work with the hardware here? Okay, pretty number of hands here. How about we learning hardware again? It'll be pretty tough, right? So hardware is we have to do a soldering, all those things, and we don't crashing the hardware much time. So instead, what we could do was we could teach the hardware about us. So what does that mean? We could do programming with the hardware through JavaScript. That's where the Tessel has come in. So Tessel is a microcontroller, which runs JavaScript. So you could do all your programming with the hardware directly in the hardware using the Tessel, okay? And it has got four ports in it. The ports are port A, port B, port C, and port D, and then GPIO port. You can connect different modules which is available there with Tessel. These are the 14 different modules which is readily available with the Tessel. So you can use any of these 14 modules. You can just directly use it with Tessel, and you could do the programming. So if you see some of the Tessel's interesting modules are camera, infrared, GPRS, GPS, relay, Bluetooth, audio, ambient, accelerometer, and et cetera, et cetera. And you might have heard about Raspberry Pi as well as the Arduino, right? You may have a question where does the Tessel lies there? In Arduino, you have to connecting Wi-Fi stuff, and you can't do programming in JavaScript. But right now, there's a possibility you could use Johnny 5 to do programming in Arduino using JavaScript. Whereas in Tessel, you can directly do it in JavaScript. You don't have to do any use any firmware to convert it into programming what you have to do with the hardware. And in case of Raspberry Pi doesn't have an Wi-Fi adapter, so you have to connect an Wi-Fi adapter to it. But you could do the programming either in Node.js or you could do in C or Python, anything. So whereas Tessel, Wi-Fi is built in, so you can readily connect to the internet. You don't have to see how to connect Tessel to the internet. Whereas in Raspberry Pi, you have to do some kind of setups before you even use the Wi-Fi adapter in it. So if I have to say Tessel is lying between, you have to put in the order first is Arduino, then the Tessel, then the Raspberry Pi, okay? And so in a summary, if you have to say what Tessel is, it runs using JavaScript and it is node compatible. And to connect to the modules, you doesn't have to solder. You can just use it directly, plug and play. And it has got the built-in Wi-Fi, which I said remote before. And you can do programming remotely. You don't have to connect it if you have got NFRD directly in your laptop and in your Tessel. And even you can use it with your mobile. And finally, installing all the packages to the NPM, that's the package manager. So it makes our life simple. Since we have the web developers, we don't have to learn something new to use Tessel. You can directly use it how you normally do your programming. And how to install the Tessel? It's very simple. Irrespective of any operating system, you can just say, if you have got Node, you have to just say npm install -g Tessel. It installs the Tessel for you. Okay. And let's see a small demo of it. So this is the Tessel. You've got four ports, as I said, and this is the GPIO, and this is the Wi-Fi adapter, and this is the processor. And these two are the 32 MB flash memories and the ROM. And this is one of the modules which I have connected now currently to it. This is the camera module in it. So the programming, we do the hello world, right? In hardware, they do the blink test. So let's run a small blink test in it. So it says Tessel and blink. So it's blinking, and here you could see the two lights are Can you see the lights are just blinking over there? To see the program, I hope this is visible, right? Yeah, okay. So how to write the blink program here? Blink is like inbuilt, so if when I say Tessel blink, it works. What is the actual programming which is done? I'll just explain here. Just like the node, as it works in node, so we have to just import the interface for Tessel. So you have to say require Tessel and import it out. And it has got two LEDs in it. So it is, first one is what here you're seeing, whatever you're seeing, the orange light, it says the Wi-Fi is connected. And before that, there is an red color LED that is, whenever there is an error, it blinks out. And next to these orange light, we have got two LEDs. That are basically accessed as LED 0 and LED 1. So to make it on, we have to just say output as 1 and output as 0 to turn it off. So I'm accessing it as LED 1 and 2, and I'm just going to make it toggle the LED's light on and off, just like how we do it in normal jQuery. It's just a toggle. And we have to just go to say like LED 1 dot toggle and LED 2 to toggle, so that like you can see the lights are like toggling off. Now I'll run this again. So to run this, the command is simple: tessel run and blinky.js. So it's now connecting to the tessel, and it's like compiling the thing. It converts basically our JavaScript into Lua, which is inbuilt compiler there in the Tessel. So this is the small programming what we have done now. So you can see like it's blinking. And now let's try something with the, before that, how do we connect to internet? As I said, it's very simple. Tessel Wi-Fi hyphen L. Okay, Tessel Wi-Fi hyphen L gives us the list of Wi-Fi connections which is available here. So it is giving three things. Currently, I'm connected to the Fedora, which is the mobile thing. And to connect to the Wi-Fi, you have to just say Tessel Wi-Fi hyphen N or hyphen N, and okay, I'll just show it here. Hyphen N the network name and hyphen P for the password. So you can just directly connect to internet just giving this one line of command. And if you have to disconnect from the Wi-Fi, you have to just say Tessel Wi-Fi hyphen D. That's it. Even you can just see the help of it. Okay, these are the commands like what we have got with respect to the Wi-Fi. So now let's see a small one more program like how to run an module, and we'll use a module here with the Tessel, and we'll run a small program to capture the images using the Tessel. Here, what I've got here now is I've got a PAR, which is an not part of the Tessel module. It is a separate thing which you have to buy from the market. So this PAR is nothing but an passive infrared sensor. So whenever you have to detect any of the objects, like you can use this, it like emits the infrared and detects any object in front of the it. So if you can see like in some of the hotels, they will just turn on the lights like the moment when you move on, right? Those kind of steps are done using this PAR. So what I have done is I have connected this PAR to the GPIO, and I have just connected, this is the input which is coming from the PAR. I have connected to the G3 pin here, and this is the camera which comes along with the Tessel. So it's just going to, what we are going to do now is whenever there is a motion in front of this PAR, we're just going to shoot a picture of it. Okay. So how do we do it? So here, as I said, like again, we have to import the Tessel as a regular thing. And since we are using the PAR from the GPIO, I have to say Tessel.port GPIO and which pin I am using it here. I'm using the pin 3, which I said earlier. And we are using the camera module. So just like how we install regular modules in Node, you have to just say npm install camera -VG0706 I have installed using directly to the package.json. And since I have connected the Tessel camera to the port A, I'm just saying use Tessel port A. And I'm just setting the compression rate for the cameras as 0.8 and resolution as VGA. It's a small VGA camera. Even if you can replace this camera with your Pixie cameras if you have like heard of it. And so it's an event-based architecture. So here everything is like say event-based. So first thing what you have to do is we have to wait for the camera to get ready. So I'm just saying camera dot on to get it ready. So once the camera is ready, we have to wait for the PA to give us a signal saying that there is some motion detected in front of it. So we are just going to say PAR.on and rise. And once this rise is there, we are just going to take a picture. I have to just say camera.take picture, and I have to just call back a function here. And I'm just checking for the error and normal steps and generating a name. And I have to just, once we get the images, have to save it. So I'm just saying process.send file, and name of the file name is here. So here, and this is the image what we are getting from the camera. That's it. I will run the demo of it now. So to run this, we have to say Tessel run index.js, and I have to say where to upload the photos, the images basically. I'm just giving hyphen upload.dir dot so that like it gets stored in our local directory where I'm trying to run this. Just running this. So it's up. So what I have to do is I have to just make a motion in front of it. Already it has detected some motion and has saved the picture here. And just a second. This is that picture. Just got saved now. I'm just making one more. Yeah, just detected one more picture which has come out now. So let me stand in front of it and you can see. Yeah, just taken one more picture of it now. Next thing, like we will try a small thing, like why don't we tweet this picture directly to the Twitter to say like we are doing it from the JS4. This is the simple same program whatever we have got here, and instead of that save, I'm sorry here. Instead of this save, I'm just going to say post an image to the tweet. This is the code for I just got my OAuth everything there. I'm just going to say post. I'm sorry. Here, instead of the process.send, I'm just going to make a tweet directly here, and let me make sure Wi-Fi is connected. Tessel run tweet. Okay. Is it with the hashtag? Oh no. Yeah, it's there with the hashtag. Oh, I'm sorry. I have to just reconnect it. Sometimes you'll get this kind of weird errors. If just to reset, you have to just unplug it and run it again. It's going out. Yeah, it's connecting to camera and yeah, it's taking a picture. And internet is slow. Yeah, just taken one more picture. Yeah. So come out here. Yeah, here we go. So that's it. I'm sorry. And if you're interested in buying Tessel, you can buy it from here. Even you can go to tessel.io and you can buy it directly. And I got the promo code for it. If you guys are interested in buying, you can just contact me. I'll give you the promo code for you. You'll get a 10% discount if you're interested in buying Tessel. That's it. Thank you. Yeah.
I'm sorry, I'm not going to get up with the laptop and stuff.
Oh, that's fine, yeah.
So you mentioned connecting to a Wi-Fi network. Now, is that possible programmatically? Like, can I do that from...
Yeah, you can do it from...
So I can just connect to
Apple. Yeah, you can connect. Yeah.
Networks.
Yeah, see, just I showed like a Tessel Blink. Mm-hmm. The program is inbuilt, just like that Wi-Fi's program is also inbuilt into it. So that like you can do the programming as well. Say like whenever there is a motion you want to connect to the internet, then you can put it.
So okay. Thank you.
How does it handle GPIO locks?
I'm sorry?
How does it handle multiple requests coming to the same GPIO pins? In terms of write locks, if multiple programs are coming and trying to access the same pin?
Haven't tried it. I've just tried with simple things only. I haven't tried with GPIO, so I'm not sure how it works there.
Suppose I load one JS in browser, so it's executed in browser and I can check the error in browser. But for hardware, where it's compiled?
JavaScript file is getting compiled into Tessel. It just bundles the JavaScript in our in the laptop, and it sends the JS bundle to the Tessel, where it gets compiled into a Lua, which is like inbuilt in Tessel, and it gets processed there. The compiling happens basically in the Tessel, not in the laptop.
Okay, so is there any architecture is defined?
Yeah, you can go and see it. Like, if you just go to the website, you can see their architecture as well there. Yeah, it's inbuilt. Yeah.
Hi. How is it different from Arduino, or in terms of capabilities or anything? Is it what are the differences that we can see?
The modules are readily available here, so you don't have to buy any hardware separately if you have to use it with Tessel.
Okay, but in terms of capabilities, I was asking.
Since you have got the GPIO port, you can mostly so many of them have returned the driver files, like in case of relay, you got it. Most of the modules are available, like if you have to see just seen pair connecting to it, then seen somebody connecting an LED lights to it. It seems to be very simple. I haven't seen any problem to it.
Okay, thank you.
Hi, another comparison question.
Yeah.
Can you compare it with the BeagleBone black?
No, I haven't done any comparison.
Because it has a web ID and hot code push.
No, I haven't done any comparison. I have no idea of that. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So how stable is it? Is it production ready right now?
Some of them are, it's like mostly people use it for prototyping it. They haven't seen anywhere just for fun we are doing it. So it's like if you want to implement anywhere, you can just do it up. Yeah.
Okay, so I'll have to switch to another controller if I want to, say, manufacture it.
Can you be loud?
So I'll have to switch to another controller, say, if I want to manufacture it on a large scale.
I didn't get you. What
so I have to switch to another controller or say, Arduino or something if I want to manufacture it on a large scale.
Yeah, you can do that. Yeah. Once you are once your prototype is up and running here, you can change it to the any controller, microcontroller you want. This is basically for running your prototypes. So you can just see without using your breadboard, you can directly run the your prototyping here and you can just test it out in any other microcontrollers as well.
Hi. Can you explain more about the architecture of the board?
Sure. Yeah.
How is it that JavaScript running on the board?
I don't have it. Let me see. If I have to say, we'll be just basically bundling all those JavaScripts from our laptop and we'll be sending it to the Tessel, where Tessel converts all these JavaScript files into an Lua, where they have it's like inbuilt in Tessel, so that like it gets compiled there. I don't remember like where exactly I've seen the architecture. Maybe like I'll show you once I'm there out there.
So that would convert JavaScript to C or C++?
It's not C, it's to Lua, L-U-A.
Okay, L-U-A. That's another programming language?
That's a programming language. Wait, let me get you that. Yeah, this is the thing. Okay, this is what they are using it inside the Tessel.
Okay, thanks.
Anything else? Anybody? Okay. Thank you.